Welcome to yet another awesome, epic, and entertaining episode of Foreign Only with the one, the only, the legendary, the controversial, but also hilarious, Floyd. The passport bro space is not an easy space to deal with. You have a lot of haters, trolls, many debates about pay for play, or why would you leave America in the first place to find women? And our boy Floyd, he gets a bad rap at times for a lot of the stuff that he does, which is questionable and controversial in most cases. However, given his travels, Floyd does give us some wisdom and some sheer entertainment value when he travels. Here is just a few bits of knowledge and a few things to make you laugh. Let's take a look.
COS, he's laughing at me, trolling me, I get it. But for the people who are genuinely listening to my advice, please get two Airbnbs. I know it's a little bit more money, but you can get cheap Airbnbs for $12, $10 a night. They got hot showers. They don't look as good, but guess what? You're not going to care about that when you're pounding the chick out anyways.
It's simple. They're like, you go to the United States, and you're taking her on fucking filet mignon, champagne, shongdi. You're taking her on to the phenomenon, champagne, Chris, with the sprinkles.
Sprinkles.
Shandi, compong, wondong, don't champagne with the ting-a-lang and ting-a-lang with the champagne with the whipped cream. These fancy-ass made-up word restaurants costing about $100, costing about $300 per meal. You gotta impress the Shandong, Shangting, Wontang, with the Tongting, talking about Hu Tong Tong, the Shantong, the King Tong. She's talking about the Cheesecake Factory, not for me, not no more.
They're not gonna do anything. They're going to most likely do what they're supposed to do and cook that meal and go by the day. And the fact is that it's not a foolproof security plan. You still can get drugged doing everything I told you to do, but it does minimize the risk by 70%, which is a great risk minimizer. See, a lot of people want to get involved. Oh, well, Floyd don't know what he's talking about. But I've never been drugged. Or in Colombia. I've never been drugged in Colombia. I've came close to once, but I'm too paranoid for that. I've came close, but guess what? I'm looking at the sign, looking at the body language. I'm too paranoid to let that happen. If it happens, you got real lucky. The moment I walk away from my drink, I don't drink it. If they drug you, you're broke and it shows. Understand this, Chris C-Man. This is C-Man. He said his name is C-Man, so I'm going to go off of that. C-Man. Here's the thing, C-Man. The women, the U.S. dollar is strong overseas. My $2,000 is broke in the United States. Yes, it's broke. I would consider myself broke making $1,000 a month over in the United States. Overseas, that's like $3,000 for them. So, of course, that's a lot of money for them. And they're going to take that money. The U.S. dollar is strong overseas. One of the reasons why I dress down in these foreign countries and I don't dress like Austin is because I don't want to get robbed. Now, Austin is a different breed entirely. Me, personally, I don't want to be. I look like an easy lick. Like, I look like an easy lick if I dress nice. I like to dress down. I only dress nice on occasions. But I'm not going to walk around with a jewelry and a nice watch and an iPhone. Just, hey, how you doing, my iPhone? I got an iPhone 15. Yeah, what's up, baby? Yeah. Then you get robbed. And that iPhone 15 is going to sell a lot further overseas than it would in the United States. An iPhone 15, maybe $1,000 in the States. Overseas, that's $3,000. They're going to sell that shit. Oh, it's a come up. That $1,000 pays their rent for at least 3 to 4 months. So, of course, they're gonna try to rob you to look good. You have to dress down. But you do whatever you want. You don't have to listen. Don't listen to me. I'm just giving you advice. You don't have to listen to me. I'm just telling you things that I would do if I was overseas. If you think a woman is going to wait on you while you're overseas for the next 9 months, you're full of shit. That's like these military guys. They go overseas to the army. They fight for their country. And they expect their American chick to wait for them for 4 years. That's not going to happen. Because she's going to want to get some. And you're not going to be able to catch her. You know why you're not going to be able to catch her? Because you're not there. There's no risk. So she's freely able to do what she wants. So how I look at it is, if I leave the country, I'm not serious. Because if I like you, I'm going to find a way to stay longer. You know what I mean? If I'm in a relationship with a chick and we're overseas, I'm in Colombia, I would find a way to stay longer. If I couldn't stay longer, I wouldn't take her seriously. Everything has a factor. And if you guys don't put that, like all these Thailand chicks, you're only there for a month or 2 months. You're not there for a year or two. If you were there for a year or two, it'd be different. But you're there for a month. So you expect the girl to be loyal to you for in a month? Like the Philippines, right? Oh, I fucked your bitch. I don't give a fuck. You got my sloppy seconds, what you did. But have fun. Have fun. You got my sloppy seconds? Have fun. Have fun. People are, oh, I messed with your girl. You bragging to me about what? I've had her first, so I don't care. You got my sloppy seconds. I don't care. Have fun. Have fun. The fact of the matter is, guys, you can't expect these four women to be loyal to you while you're in your own company. This is why I'm too paranoid. I don't trust no chick. I don't care what country I'm in. It's a better deal dealing with women overseas. It's a better deal because you're more likely to have fun and have a great experience with women in overseas. In America, it's not like that. You can have a chick for a night, and you know you may not get them for the next 2 years in the States. You got these guys following these chicks and being friend zoned by these women in America. Some chicks in a foreign country tried that bullshit. I said, no, hell no. I said, we can be cool, but I got other friends to deal with. You know what I mean? So a lot of you guys are coming on, going out of your way to be friends on by a chick. Now, if I'm not attracted to you, I'll be your friend. But if I'm clearly attracted and you tell me let's be friends, go on somewhere with that. I'd rather not see you. I'd rather just cut you off right in there, then and there. I don't want to see with other men if I'm attracted to you, right? So I would just leave you be. I would just leave you alone and cut you off. I wouldn't even talk to you no more. I've had women block me on WhatsApp. And then a week later, they apologize. Oh, I got this guy. He was a dick. You were the good dude. Yeah, I know I was a good man. I don't want you though, sweetheart. You blocked me. You treat me like shit. I'll let you go. So, how do two people get drugged by the same woman? Because you drink. Look, guys, if me and Austin were dealing with women in Colombia and we were both together, he drinks. I don't. I would be too paranoid to let something happen to Austin. Me and Austin have our ups and downs, right? But I would be too paranoid, too vigilant to let something happen to Austin. I would be too vigilant. I mean, anybody else around, I would be too paranoid. Even when I was around George. Like, I'm like, hey, don't walk away from your drink. When I was around Jay Rillo, I said, make sure, watch her make your drink for you, man. Watch her make her drink. I was always vigilant when I'm around people because all it takes is one slip up and it's over with, and I can't risk that. And, well, you're just paranoid being in Colombia, and you're paranoid, bro. He's paranoid. He ends up being paranoid, bro. They're known for drugging foreigners. You have to be paranoid.
Thank you once again for watching another epic episode of Foreign Only, where we talk any and everything about traveling overseas. Please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe so you can know when new videos drop and when the legendary Floyd goes live. if there are any other moments that you can think of that you thought were hilarious, please comment below. We'll be looking at the comments just to see what other epic Floyd moments that you recall, and we can put together for a nice little video for you. And remember, if you want to keep supporting our boy Floyd, if you want to help our boy Floyd get back overseas, get back over to Asia and other travels around the world, hit the Cash App. Hit the Cash App. Hit the Cash App, because it helps the channel grow. It supports the channels and it keeps the content coming. We want to thank you again for watching, and until next time.